Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and authority rests on his shoulders, and he is called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. Friends, welcome to St. Andrew's Christmas Eve family service. I'm glad to see you all, new faces and old ones. My name is Daniel, I'm the minister here at St. Andrew's. And if you don't have any place of worship yet, St. Andrew's is open for you. You are welcome to come again next Sunday. If you don't have any place of worship, I'll be happy. We will be happy to see you again. Let us start our Christmas service with sings number 159, O Come All Ye Faithful. I invite you to stand if you are able.
Come all ye faithful, joyful and joyous.
hear our call to worship, and you are invited to join in the bold sentences. In the beginning was the Word. In the Word was light. The light shines in the darkness. So let us worship God in wonder and in love, trusting in God's light. Let us pray. God of mystery and mercy, you stir in our hearts and bring us joy. You stir in our minds and bring us wisdom. You stir in the world and bring hope for the future. You came as a little child, stirring up praise. We come to adore you with the angels, to bow with the shepherds, to kneel in wonder with the Magi, to ponder your mystery with Joseph, to love and cherish you with Mary. We come with humble hearts, full of joy, because you came to us first in Jesus, whom we hold on our hearts tonight. Amen.
The angels sing the glory of God in the highest heavens.
Be not afraid, for I bring you good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom God favors.
At Christmas, God speaks in signs. The baby in the manger is a sign of new life and new governance shining in the world. Christ is born, and the world is filled with promise of hope, signs of peace, joy, and incarnation of God's love.
Holy are you, source of all new life among us. Jesus Christ is the light of the world. We join with all creation in joyful praise.
Thank you, Chase and Clint. Friend, let us sing Away in the Manger, hymn number 149, and if you are able, I invite you to stand.
Thank you.
welcome to join me for the prayer of confession. We're going to pray this prayer in unison. God of grace and truth, in Christ you offer us the gift of yourself, but we are attracted to presence under the tree. You came to us in flesh and blood, but we fail to see you in the humans right beside us. You shine in the world, but we dwell on the darkness in the daily news. Forgive us, renew our hope and our trust in you as you reach out to us from the manger. Amen. Friends, tonight, receive the gift of God's forgiveness. God's love and God's peace offer to you in Jesus Christ. And know that this gift is for you, and share this gift with others too, in Jesus' name. So let us, if you feel comfortable, let us pass the love of Christ to one another. Love of Christ be with you all. Friends, tonight St. Andrew's Choir will sing, will perform ministry of music called the Song Chill of the Nightfall. Enjoy and be blessed. Thank you, Lafine and Sandra Squire. Friends, this is children time. So, or we call it young at heart. So if you are not children, but you are young at heart, you are welcome to come forward and sit with me, and we're going to share stories. I'm going to share a story with you. So please come forward. Don't be shy. Children or anyone young at heart, you are very welcome to come forward. And parents, you can join also. There you go. All right, have a seat on the steps. There you go. Have a seat, over here, go ahead, sit down. Good to see you, Merry Christmas all. So, you're going to have to look me and also look at the skin. Tonight we're going to talk about this theme, unto us a child is born. And I want to show you the greatest moment in my life when a child is born. Boom. Oh. This is my son, maybe December 2013 at that time, 10 years ago. So when he was born, I was a new man immediately. I'm different. I'm a new man, happy. Now, when a child is born, either two of these. Either they speak first or they walk first. Which one are you? You walk first or you speak first? You speak first. How about you? You speak first or you walk first? You remember? You speak. Anthony, you speak or you walk? You walk as you speak. Ty? Ty, you walk or you speak? They don't remember? So you mentioned you speak. What your first word? What was your first word? You don't remember your first word. Well, my son speak first before he walks. And can you guess his first word? Not Dada, not Mama, not Jesus. No. His first word is so weird. But this one word makes me connect with him. He can laugh out loud whenever I say this word. This is his first word. Hajigabah. Hajigabah. Whenever he says that word, and I say it back to him, he laughs out loud. He was so happy. Well, this one word, hajigabah, makes me connect with him in such a way that is so special. Well, not anymore now. Whenever I say hajigabah, there is no connection anymore now. But at that time, we connect so much. Then I was wondering, I talked to my wife, what word is this? So we remember when he was small, before he began to speak, he loves to watch this cartoon. Masha and the Bear. This is Russian cartoon. So maybe hajigabah is Russian word. I do not know. So this is Masha and the Bear. So now I want to share with you. What is one word? One word that connect me with my son at the time, hajigabah. What is one word that connect us with God? I want to introduce you this word. Jesus, yes, this word. Look on the screen now. Incarnation. Shall we say it together? Incarnation. Incarnation. This one word connect the creation with the Creator. What is that incarnation? Anybody knows? Such a big word. What is this?
Invisible manifestation of something spiritual.
You're right. There you go. So, a person who embodies in the flesh a divine deity, spirit, or abstract quality. So, you see, when Jesus incarnate, choose in the form of human beings, we, creation, now can connect with God. Thanks to Jesus, now we have connection. And then Bible says, God was pleased, happy to have all his fullness dwell in Jesus. So you see, in Jesus, we can see all the fullness of God and we can connect with God. So thanks to Jesus, through Christmas, we are reminded that we can reconnect to God. Thanks to Jesus. Yeah, reconnect again, like Ajagaba. Like that. We reconnect through incarnation. We connect with Jesus again. So thanks be to God. Now we are going to celebrate this connection, reconnection with Jesus. And we are going to sing together, Little Drummer Boy.
Hear the word of God, Isaiah 9, verse 6. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. God of mystery and manger, as we listen to the story of your love born for us in a child of flesh and blood. Help us to grasp that love with the trust of a baby grasping a parent's finger, the trust that all will be well. Amen. Unto us a child is born. Friends, Christmas is a time when we reflect on the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Christmas is also a time when we celebrate, in particular, the fact that God the Creator chose that most vulnerable of humans, a child, in order to bring forth His divine and purpose for the salvation of humanity. They say children bring hope of reconciliation. Now there is a lovely story I read, story of reconciliation from Japan. A man from Nara, Japan, his name is Otou Katayama. This man, Otou, chose to remain silent and not to speak a single word to his wife, Yumi Katayama. Can you guess for how long? 2 decades, 20 years. This unusual behavior began due to Otto, the husband, feeling neglected and resentful when Yumi, his wife, focused more on their children after their birth. So childish. Yumi, the wife, despite Otto's silence, continued to interact like normal to her husband, speaking to him, carrying on with their family life. However, Otto only responded with nods, head shakes, or unclear grumble. Their children, Yoshiki, the boy 18 years old at that time, and their two older daughters, 21 and 25, they couldn't recall the last time they witnessed their parents speaking to each other. Can you imagine being their children? For 20 years, they don't see their parents speak to one another. Grew up in a family just like that. Yoshiki, the youngest, troubled by the situation, and then he reached out to a local television station, hoping to improve the relationship between his parents. During an interview with the TV, local TV station, he mentioned that his father never spoke to his mother, therefore creating a one-sided form of communication within the family. The TV station intervened by arranging a meeting for Otto and Yumi at the park where they first met. So, initially hesitant, but then Otto eventually broke the silence after some time sitting quietly. And then he expressed, after 20 years, he expressed his feelings to Yumi, acknowledging her dedication to their children and expressing gratitude for her efforts, finally breaking his silence. Moved by Otto's words, their children watched from a distance, shedding tears of emotion. Otto and Yumi promised they're going to mend their relationship and ensure that their future wouldn't be shadowed by silence again. So this touching reunion marked the beginning of a renewed bond between the husband and wife after 2 decades of silence. And thanks to their youngest son, Yoshiki, for coming up with an idea to speak with the local TV station. Because of him, his parents now reconciled. Children bring hope of reconciliation. A famous writer, a poet by the name of Rabindranath Tagore, he once said this: every child comes with the message that God is not yet discouraged of man. In other words, he says that children are a symbol of hope, and then God still has faith in humanity. So when Isaiah announced that for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, Isaiah is sending a message to us that our God is not discouraged and our God does not give up on His creation. God doesn't give up on you or on me. Thanks to His Son, unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. God gives His one and only Son to be born unto us so that He can reconcile us with Himself. Because there is no way, my friends, to bring this reconciliation to completion without letting His Son to be born unto us. Now, in the history, there was a dark period of time. This dark period of time is known as intertestamental period, a period in between Old Testament and before New Testament. This intertestamental period was a time in history where God was silent for 400 years. You heard me correctly, 400 years of silence. During this long period of silence, God did not send even one single prophet to speak on His behalf. Because God already spoke to them in the Old Testament, both directly and through His prophets. But people refused to listen to Him and His prophets. So God, for crazy reason in the history, was silent for 400 years before the arrival of Jesus, recorded in the Gospel of Matthew. My friends, what Jesus did when He was born unto us, He is breaking the longest silence in history. As if Jesus is saying to His Father, Father, you don't have to send prophets again. This time, send me down to earth. Let me be born among them. Let me be one of them. I will speak to them on your behalf, and I will speak for them on their behalf. Let me bring a true reconciliation between them and us. You see, the birth of Jesus Christ unto us is such a gift. In Jesus, we can now reconnect with God in harmony again. No more sin that separates us from God. Unto us, for unto us a child is born. This part not only closing the gap between us and God, and it also reveals a statement about Jesus' humanity. Jesus is fully human when He was born. Unto us as a baby, He began life like any other human, as an infant. Isaiah doesn't say about this more, but we can know from the New Testament that Jesus experienced every temptation common to humanity, yet He never sinned. As a man, as a human, Jesus felt everything that you feel, hurt the way you hurt, wept the way you weep, and in His death, He even felt the weight of sin as He took upon Himself our sins. And the next sentence says, to us, unto us, a son is given. This one speaks of His divine nature of Jesus. By saying given instead of born, Isaiah suggests that Jesus has existed even long before His birth into humanity. Long before Jesus was given to us to be our Savior, He was already God, the second person of Trinity. Philippians 2, 6 to 8 declares this divine nature beautifully. Though He was in the form of God, He did not count equality with God, but emptied Himself by taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of man, and being found in human form, He humbled Himself by becoming obedient. Obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Friends, Christmas is indeed a cosmic event. On Christmas, the Creator of the universe suspends His heavenly majesty simply to join humanity as a fully human in the flesh while remaining fully God at the same time. You see, it can be easy to see incarnation as a generic and abstract and philosophical concept, but Isaiah doesn't say God embraced humanity. That's too abstract. Isaiah says, unto us a child is born. So concrete. Unto us a child is born declares that Jesus is not born near us. Or Jesus born at us. No, Jesus born to us, for us. Have you ever received your neighbor's package accidentally delivered to you? I experienced that once. This package perhaps arrived at that time within like 95 feet of its intended destination between me and my neighbor's house. Well, thanks be to God, Jesus doesn't land in the proximity of our lives. Jesus comes unto us, directly to us. For unto us a child is born, to us a son is given. So don't you see how blessed we are to be embraced by God, whose love is so amazing that he became one of us, became incarnate into the flesh so that he could live among us, show us the way of salvation, to lift our burdens, to increase our joy. How blessed are we to be embraced by such a loving God, whose love embraces all that we are and loves us even when we misuse, abuse, or otherwise push away the gift of love offered freely to us in Jesus Christ, a love that offers godly justice and true peace. How blessed we are that our loving God surrounds us with the light that breaks us free from the darkness of a world that has yet fully embraced the loving and the liberating and life-giving gift of the Word made flesh. This love that is full of patience and enthusiasm for us, and our expected action is nothing but to be open to this grand offering of love. Friends, the prophetic message of Christmas is the good news of God's answer to all of confusion, chaos, complexities, and conflicts of life. It is the gift of a newborn infant who is also the father of all eternity. He is an innocent child, yet he is a wise counselor at the same time, and mighty king. He is God with us, Emmanuel. God came to live with us in Christ Jesus so that we may dwell with him. So next time, my friends, if you ever wonder how far God would go to make sure that you are his own, look down into the manger, look down to the stable, and then look up to the cross. There is your answer. Jesus' first and last cry is given unto you. His first cry was a cry longing for reconnection. Imagine 400 years of silence. He longs to connect you with his Father. And his last cry on the cross, his last cry was a cry of longing for your salvation, so that through his death, his final cry, you may have life in him. My friends, I wish you and your family the blessings of Christmas. Unto you a child is born. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Amen. Friends, soon we are going to have communion together. So this is just invitation for you, whichever denomination you come from, or maybe no denomination, no affiliation, you are welcome to join for the Holy Communion. We are going to take the bread and the cup together. So when you receive, keep it with yourself, and I'll give instruction and we will take the bread and cup together. So hear the invitation for the communion. Come to this table, you who have much faith, and you who would like to have more. You have been to this sacrament often, and you who have not been for a long time, you are welcome here. You who have tried to follow Jesus, and you who have failed, you are also welcome here. So come, it is Christ who invites us to meet him here. Unto you, a child is born, and unto you, this child died on the cross for you. Please remain seated. The servers will come and distribute the elements to you, and we will take the elements together. I would like to invite the servers to come forward.
Forever, King.
Everybody receive the elements. Friend, I invite you to stand. Hear the story of the Last Supper. One night, when Jesus was his disciples, while they were eating, he took a loaf of bread, and after blessing this bread, he broke it and then he said, "Take and eat. This is my body, broken for the redemption of your sins. Let us eat the bread together." Then Jesus took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave the cup to them, saying, "Drink from it, all of you, because this is my blood of covenant, poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins." Friends, let us take the wine cup together. As often as we eat this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes again. As Jesus gave thanks to God for the gifts of the earth, so let us give thanks for what we receive from God's hand today. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, we are so grateful for the gifts you just shared with us from this table, for we know what they cost you. Send us out in the strength of your spirit, unafraid of what service in your name will cost us. For we will be faithful to you, now and always. Amen. Please be seated. Friend, often the very best gifts are given quietly, even anonymously. And yet such gifts have the power to change lives. God's gift in the Christ child arrived in a small town, in a humble manger, to a couple no one invited in. And still, that gift changes lives. Your gift tonight, our gifts tonight to God this Christmas, share in that miracle of new life. So as the offering plate is being distributed, we're going to hear Ministry of Music, He Is Born, handbell quartet by David, Fiona Lavinia, and Brad Parker. Thank you. Thank you, the Parker and the Millers, for your ministry of music. For your gift, let us pray together.
Generous and loving God, your gift to us in Christ Jesus still draws us to manger and opens our hearts with wonder. So bless our gifts in your name, so that our gifts may draw others to your love and to find the blessing we have discovered in the one born unto us tonight. Amen.
Friends, you are welcome to join for the candlelight service. You have your tea lights in your hands. We're going to turn the lights off, and we're going to sing Silent Night together.
Oh.
Please be seated. Friends, we are almost at the end of this service. Just a kind reminder, after you dismiss from this place, please leave the tea lights in the box on the way out from here. We're going to sing Glory to God. I don't know what's in Dutch, how to say it, but it's just, there's a Dutch language here. So again, I invite you to stand to sing both in English or in Dutch or Indonesia, whatever you want. Let's stand up. Hear the benediction in English. Friends, may you live with a twinkle of bright lights in your eyes. May the joyous sounds of Christmas ringing in your ears, and a vision of a Savior in your mind, the spirit of the season in your memory, the joy of the season in your life, and the faith of Christ's child in your soul, and the message of the season on your lips. Unto you a child is born, unto you a son is given. Amen. We wish you a Merry Christmas.
Sorry.